Dan, great to see you. I know it's been a long road here. Really excited that we're finally announcing this partnership publicly.
I'm glad we've endured. Finally, we're actually getting this partnership out into the real world and creating real impact. It's a bit counterintuitive, actually, that we would be partnering with Coke. You see some of their products turning up in our systems along with everybody else's. And therefore, it's good that they're investing and taking leadership and actually solving this problem.
You know, I've been a fan of the ocean cleanup for a long time, probably since I saw Boyd's first TED Talk years ago. But I think what really cemented the idea in my mind about a partnership was when I visited the Interceptor in Rotterdam Harbor and was able to go out and see the Interceptor in action.
At the ocean cleanup, the reason we exist is to rid the world's oceans of plastic. And within that, there's two main jobs to be done. One is to rid the oceans of existing plastic. And the second job is to stop plastic flowing into oceans, so to turn off the tap. You know, as an organization, we see the problem with single-use plastics. And for us, in the future, ideally, they wouldn't be there. And we just agree to disagree in that. And we see the benefit of circular activity. Where we do agree, right, is that neither of us want plastic waste in the environment.
You know, we're very sensitive to the point of view of the ocean cleanup on this matter. And it's not just a point of view held by the ocean cleanup. You know, many environmental activists and consumers have that same point of view. You know, we have established a virgin plastic reduction target. Over the next 5 years, we'll in effect be taking out the equivalent of 1 year's usage of PET plastic from our supply chain. But I want to stress the importance of having this productive tension in the partnership.
Yeah, and partnering is actually one of our key values in the ocean cleanup, simply because we know the job to be done can't be done by one party alone.
They're sitting here with the technology that in order to really make a true global impact, they've got to scale it. We'll place 15 interceptors in rivers around the world and really learn, you know, together about how this really works.
An interceptor itself is a solar-powered, unmanned, 25-meter-long trash harvester to an extent. We use the natural forces of the current to actually direct plastic to the barrier, which then is taken into the interceptor through a conveyor belt. And when the interceptor is full, the operator receives a notification remotely and comes to remove the waste, all the dumpsters offloaded on shore for sorting and recycling.
And this is really one of the more exciting pieces of it for us, for each of these local places. There'll be local Coke teams that can engage in this. And so it's not just about the 15 rivers, or the 15 countries that we go into and place interceptors. There will be other opportunities for employee engagement, consumer engagement. And so we really see this as a first phase and not just about 15 places we'll go, but a truly global partnership. You know, I'd love to be able to sit here a year from now, 18 months from now and say all 15 were a success. I mean, we know there are going to be challenges in some areas.
We live a moonshot when we go to work every day. It's derived from Boyan's vision. The exciting thing for us is that moonshot is becoming a reality.
Dan, it was great talking to you today. Really excited to get things kicked off and excited about what we can do together with Coke teams around the world.
Great, Ben. Thanks. Same to you. I think the exciting part is that the work only starts now. So really looking forward to kind of rolling up our sleeves with the teams on both sides and making this happen.